Today, we're going to be learning a bit about the 3D cursor in Blender, what it's used for, and how it can really help speed up your workflow. First of all, if we want to move our 3D cursor, we can hold down the Shift key and then press right click, and you'll notice our 3D cursor will move to wherever we click. Keep in mind though, this works in 3D space, so it might not necessarily show up where you want it to. You can of course left click this button here on the left side panel, and if you click this button here, when you left click, it'll move the cursor as well. So if you forget the hotkey, that's another way to do it. I'll go back to my select box mode, which is the default. There are more ways to move the cursor. First of all, there is the Shift S menu. This will open a pie menu, which will allow you to move your cursor in a few different ways. Also allows you to move your selected objects in certain ways as well. You can see here we have cursor to grid, cursor to world origin, cursor to selected, and cursor to active. The main one we want to think about right now is cursor to world origin, which will reset it to the default position. But why is the 3D cursor important in the first place? Well, one thing you'll notice is when I press Shift A to open the add menu, and under mesh, I'll choose cube. You can see the cube has been added to where the 3D cursor is. And you'll notice if I press Shift right click to move my cursor and press Shift A again and choose cube, you'll see the cube has now appeared where the 3D cursor is. So that is one of the first applications of the 3D cursor, is deciding where new objects will be created. I'll press X to delete that object, and I'm going to press Shift S and then choose cursor to world origin to put it back to the middle. Now we know roughly what the 3D cursor does by default and how we can move it, let's talk a little bit about how else it can be useful. First of all, we can actually move it in more different ways. So let's say for example I want to move the cursor to this bottom corner here of this cube. I'll explain why this could be useful in a minute. I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode, and I'm going to press 1 on the keyboard to go into vertex select mode. You can see now I can select individual points. I'm going to choose this point here, and now I can open up that Shift S menu again, and this time I'm going to choose cursor to selected. That will move the cursor to whatever object or individual point or set of points that we have selected. I'll press tab to come back into object mode. Now we've gone and done that, you might be wondering why this is even useful in the first place. Right now, if I press R to rotate my object, you can see it's rotating around the origin. The origin is that tiny white dot in the middle, and it also has a lot of use cases. An older video of mine covers the origin and how it can be useful, if you're interested in watching that too. However, we can actually use this 3D cursor as an anchor point to rotate around as well. So I can, for example, come up to here where it says transform pivot point. You can see we've got a bunch of options here. And the option we're looking for is 3D cursor. If I left click this, I can then press R, and now you'll notice the cube will rotate around the 3D cursor. I'll press tab to go back into edit mode. Another useful application is moving things to that point. So of course you could use the magnet for this as well, but there's multiple ways of doing things in Blender. So I'm going to show you this way too. So I could select this point, for example, and I could move it to where the cursor is. And remember, we had our cursor at where the other point is, which means it will line up perfectly. So with my point selected, I can press Shift S again. Remember how I mentioned that we can move our selections as well using this menu. So I can choose selection to cursor. You can see it's moved that point straight down to the cursor. These tools can be really handy for when you're doing rigging and stuff as well, if you want to line up some bones, as I find the magnet doesn't always work as well with those. Also, since we have this set to transform pivot point at 3D cursor, that means when we scale and things like that, it's going to scale from that point. So you can start to see immediately how this can be quite useful, and it means we don't have to change our origin point as well. So again, giving us a little bit more flexibility. And yeah, that just about covers it. I thought I'd go over some of the useful features with the 3D cursor. If you guys know any more, feel free to let me know in the comment section below, and maybe we can make a part 2 to this video. If you want to learn more quick tips in Blender, I highly recommend checking out my Blender Quick Tips playlist, which has new videos being added to it almost every day. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.